What is going on, everyone? Adam Allert here with PragmaticWays.com, and in today's video, we're going to be learning how to add JavaFX to Eclipse, the easy way. So for those of you who would like to follow along with an actual readme type of tutorial or something, I got this little blog article here on my blog at PragmaticWays.com, and it sort of just illustrates all the different steps that we're going to be performing today. And it's got a bunch of screenshots and everything else, so it makes it very simple and easy to follow along with. So a link to this is going to be in the description below. So make sure you smash that like button and please do consider subscribing. And how to add JavaFX to Eclipse is coming up next. Stick around. So the first step we're actually going to do here is just download JavaFX. And in order to do that, we're going to go to gluonhq.com. So I'm going to go ahead and right click and open this in a new tab. And I already had it up, but so we're going to be downloading the SDK version. So make sure you download the SDK, but make sure you download it for your operating system as well as your architecture. So if you're running Linux on ARM64, you would want to make sure you download this one and not this one or this one. Or if you're running Mac on ARM64, you would download this one, or Mac with Intel 64. Or Windows Intel 64, you would download this one. Or Windows 32-bit, you would want to download this one here. So, you know, obviously just make sure you're downloading the correct operating system and architecture, and make sure you're actually downloading the SDK itself. So once you do that, I'll go ahead and just show what that looks like here. It's going to be downloading a zip file. Okay. Now you're going to want to put the zip file somewhere that you can remember where it's going to be. So wait a million years for this to actually download here. All right, so now you're going to want to put the zip folder somewhere where you're actually going to be able to remember where it is. So for instance, you could put it right inside documents, which is where I already put it. Now you're going to want to go ahead and unzip this. And when you unzip it, you know, give it a certain name. I happen to already unzip it, so I'm just going to leave it there like that. And we can close back out all of these, and let's go ahead and we can close this and go back to our instructions here now. And then it tells us to unzip it, put it in a memorable place. And now we're going to go ahead and create a user library inside of Eclipse. And what this is going to allow us to do is basically be able to very quickly add these jar files to our project whenever we want. Because usually, every time you create a new JavaFX project, you'd have to go in and extract these jars and add them back into Eclipse every time. We're going to make it very easy for ourselves for all the JavaFX projects that we ever want to do in the future. And to do that, we're going to be creating a user library. So let's go ahead and jump into Eclipse now. And in order to create a user library, I'm going to go ahead to Preferences. It should be very similar if you're running on Windows. I think it might be in like Window over here somewhere else. But basically, you just want to go to the Preferences pane inside of Eclipse. And then from here, we're going to want to go to Java, and then Build Path, and then User Libraries. Now, yours might be empty at this point. Mine already has JavaFX, but we're just going to go ahead and create a new one anyways. So we will click on New. And I'll name this JavaFX2, for instance. And I'll just go ahead and click OK. And now what we want to do is we want to add external jars. So I'm going to click on the Add External Jars button here. And now we want to navigate to where that folder was, where we unzipped that folder at. So I unzipped it right here. I'm going to double click on that. And then I'm going to double click on the lib folder because we want to get all the actual jar files from this folder here. So I'm just going to go ahead and highlight all the different jar files here, and I'm going to click on Open. And then it should look something like this. You could drop them all down, and we'll see that we have all the actual jar files that we need, and that's pretty much it. We'll go ahead and apply and close. And now we have a new user library just for our JavaFX stuff. And that was that step, goes through all of that. Now what we want to do is we need to create a JRE clone with the required VM arguments. Because if you were to try and start your JavaFX project now, you would have all the jars and all the classes passed and everything else that you need in order to run it, but you don't have the required VM arguments. And you would end up getting some error that sort of looks like this if you go to the open JFX documents on how to start, whatever else. And you would run the project, they're going to say, hey, you might get this error if you're missing the VM arguments. So all we need to do here is just add these VM arguments. If it's this one if you're running a Mac and Linux, it's this one if you're running a Windows. And it tells you how to add them into your run configuration, but we're not going to do that because, again, every different JavaFX project that you need to start, you'd have to go and edit the run configurations and everything else every single time. We're going to make it, again, really easy for us and just build a new JRE clone inside of Eclipse. So with that already has the VM arguments applied to it. So in order to do that, we're going to go back into Eclipse here, and we're going to go back to preferences again. And almost the same spot, we're going to go to Java, and this time we're going to go to installed JREs. And now all you need to do is just click on your default JRE and click. You can either click edit or duplicate. I'll just go ahead and do duplicate. And I'm going to name this one, for instance, JRE with JavaFX, name it something like that. Why not? And now here's where we're going to put in the default VM arguments. So we can go ahead and just copy this one if you're on Windows, or copy this one if you're on Mac. I'm on a Mac, so I'm going to go ahead and Control C that. But now here's another part. Let's take notice right here. You're going to want to change that with the actual path that you have it at. So when you paste it in, all right, we're going to be looking for that lib folder again where we got our external jars earlier, and we want to actually replace this path all the way up to that lib folder there. So for me, mine was in Documents, and then this folder here, and then this folder here. On a Mac, I should be able to just right-click here and do something like an Info. I should just be able to do this, actually. Control-C, okay? And then go back over into Eclipse here, and I'm going to replace all the way up to here with a Control-V. There we go. And now I have a new path. Now I put in my path to where that lib folder actually is. And that's it. Now just go ahead and click Finish. And there, now you have a new JRE with the JavaFX arguments applied to it. So we can go ahead and click Apply and Close. And now it's as simple as when you want to create a new JavaFX project, very simple. We'll go ahead and click New Project. And I'll name this My Really Cool JavaFX Project, okay? And usually you're probably going to have under the JRE section is use the execution environment JRE. You're probably going to have that one selected. What we're going to do now instead is click the use project specific JRE. And now we can do our new JRE JavaFX JRE that we just created. And that's it. Then you'll just create it and you would have all the class libraries in there. The VM arguments would already be in there. Very quick and simple and easy now for you to create brand new JavaFX projects every single time inside of Eclipse. So hopefully that was easy to follow along. If you need to go a little bit slower or want the screenshots for more validation, again, come back to this blog article. A link to this will be in the description below. So I hope that helped you all. If it did, please do consider liking and subscribing, because pretty soon I'm going to be coming out with a lot of different tutorials on how to create different types of applications and GUIs using JavaFX. So hope to see y'all there. Until next time, everyone, happy coding.